إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله، أما بعد، فإن خير الحديث كتاب الله وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وآله وسلم، شر الأمور محدثاتها كل محدثة بدعة وكل بدعة ضلالة وكل ضلالة في النار. إن شاء الله we have the class of tafsir from سورة البقرة. That's سورة number 2 verse 144. أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. قد نرى تقلب وجهك في السماء فلنولينك قبلة ترضاها فولي وجهك شطر المسجد الحرام وحيثما كنتم فولوا وجوهكم شطرة وإن الذين أوتوا الكتاب ليعلمون أنه الحق من ربهم وما الله بغافل عما يعملون ولئن أتيت الذين أوتوا الكتاب بكل آية ما تبعوا قبلتك وما أنت بتابع قبلتهم وما بعضهم بتابع قبلة بعض ولئن اتبعت أهواءهم من بعد ما جاءك من العلم إنك إذا لمن الظالمين الذين آتيناهم الكتاب يعرفونه كما يعرفون أبناءهم وإن فريقا منهم ليكتمون الحق وهم يعلمون الحق من ربك فلا تكونن من الممترين. إن شاء الله we need one brother who read the interpretation from verse 144 to 147. 144 to 147.
Verily, we have seen the turning of your Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam face towards the heaven. Surely we shall turn you to a Qibla, prayer direction, that shall please you. So turn your face in the direction of Al-Masjid Al-Haram, Al-Mecca. And whosoever you people are, turn your faces in prayer in that direction. Certainly the people who are given the scripture, i.e. the Jews and the Christians, know well that you're turning towards the direction of the Kaaba at Mecca in prayers is the truth from their Lord. And Allah is not unaware of what they do. And even if you were to bring to the people of the scripture, Jews and Christians, all the ayat, proofs, evidences, verses, lessons, signs, revelations, etc., they would not follow your qibla, prayer direction, nor are you going to follow their qibla, prayer direction. And they will not follow each other's qibla. Verily, if you follow their desires, after that which you have received of knowledge from Allah, then indeed you will be one of the dhalimun, polytheists, wrongdoers. Those to whom we gave the scripture, Jews and Christians, recognize Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, or the Kaaba at Mecca, as they recognize their sons. But verily a party of them conceal the truth while they know it, i.e. the qualities of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, which are written in the Torah, and the Injil, the Gospel. This is the truth from your Lord, so be you not one of those who doubt.
قال الشيخ إمام عبد الرحمن سعد رحمه الله في قول الله عز وجل قد نرى تقلب وجهك في السماء يقول الله لنبيه قد نرى تقلب وجهك في السماء أي كثرة تردده في جميع جهاته شوقا وانتظارا لنزول الوحي باستقبال الكعبة، وقال وجهك وجهك، ولم يقل بصرك لزيادة اهتمامه، ولأن تقليب الوجه مستلزم لتقليب البصر. فلنولينك أي نوجهك لولايتنا إياك قبلة ترضاها أي تحبها، وهي الكعبة. وفي هذا بيان لفضله وشرفه صلى الله عليه وسلم، حيث إن الله تعالى يسارع في رضاه، ثم صرح له باستقبالها فقال فولي وجهك شطر المسجد الحرام. والوجه ما أقبل من بدن الإنسان، وحيثما كنتم أي من بر وبحر، شرق وغرب، جنوب وشمال، فولوا وجوهكم شطر أي جهته. ففيها اشتراط استقبال الكعبة للصلوات كلها، فرضها ونفلها، وأنه إن أمكن استقبال عينها وإلا فيكفي شطرها وجهتها، وأن الالتفات بالبدن مبطل للصلاة، لأن الأمر بالشيء نهي عن ضده. ولما ذكر تعالى فيما تقدم المعترضين على ذلك من أهل الكتاب وغيرهم، وذكر جوابهم، ذكر هنا أن أهل الكتاب والعلم منهم يعلمون أنك في ذلك على حق وأمر، لما يجدونه في كتبهم فيعترضون عنادا وبغيا، فإذا كانوا يعلمون بخطئهم فلا تبالوا بذلك، فإن الإنسان إنما يغمه اعتراض من اعترض عليه إذا كان الأمر مشتبها وكان ممكن أن يكون معه صواب. فأما إذا تيقن أن الصواب والحق مع المعترض عليه، وأن المعترض معاند، عارف ببطلان قوله، فإنه لا محل للمبالاة، بل ينتظر بالمعترض العقوبة الدنيوية والأخروية. فلهذا قال تعالى وما الله بغافل عما يعملون، بل يحفظ عليهم أعمالهم ويجازيهم عليها، وفيها وعيد للمعترضين وتسلية للمؤمنين. In this ayah, in Surah Al-Baqarah, verse 144, Allah Azza wa Jalla said, قَدْ نَرَى تَقَلُّبَ وَجِهِكَ قَدْ نَرَى تَقَلُّبَ وَجِهِكَ Verily we have seen the turning of your face, or the Messenger of Allah Muhammad, في السماء, towards the heaven. We see the turning of your face towards the heaven, which means Prophet ﷺ, before Allah changed the direction of the prayer from Bayt al-Maqdis to Kaaba, Prophet ﷺ used to love so much the direction to be turned to the Kaaba, because it is the Kaaba built by Prophet Ibrahim. It was where the Prophet Ibrahim used to face an Ismail. Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam used to love it. So he used to face so much towards the heaven, waiting revelation from the heaven, because the revelation comes from Allah, and Allah is above the heaven. يدبر الأمر من السماء. Allah controls the matters from the heaven إلى الأرض, to the earth. So Prophet ﷺ used to face the heaven, the sky, used to turn his face to up, expecting and willing to get a message from Allah Azza wa Jal. So Allah said, Subhanahu wa ta'ala, Nara, we see. This is a description of Allah, that Allah sees, Subhanahu wa ta'ala. فَلَنُوَلِّيَنَّكَ قِبْلَةً تَرْضَاهَا We shall turn you, surely we'll turn you to a qibla, prayer direction that shall please you. تَرْضَاهَا أي تُحِبُّهَا. This is promise from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to his messenger Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, that Allah will command the messenger to face in prayer towards a direction which he loves. He is pleased with it, which is the Kaaba. فَوَلِّ وَجْهَكَ شَطْرَ الْمَسْجِدِ الْحَرَامِ. Then this is the command. فَوَلِّ وَجْهَكَ, so turn your face, شَطْرَ الْمَسْجِدِ الْحَرَامِ, in the direction of المسجد الحرام. So if the person is in the Masjid al-Haram and he can see the Kaaba, he must see. You must face the Kaaba itself. That's if you can see it. Any part of the Kaaba. But the one who doesn't see the Kaaba, then he faces the direction of the Kaaba, wherever he may be on the planet, in the universe. Wherever the direction of the Kaaba is, Masjid al-Haram is, he faces. Even if he mistake, it happened that he was facing other direction, maybe close countries, is valid. That's what Allah command. The direction of the Kaaba, of the Masjid al-Haram. So it is one of the conditions of the prayer. Salah is invalid without facing the direction of the Masjid al-Haram. وَحَيْثُمَا كُنْتُمْ فَوَلُّوا وُجُوهَكُمْ شَطْرًا. That was the first command was towards the Prophet ﷺ, to face sallallahu alayhi wa his face in the direction of al-Masjid al-Haram. And this command is to the followers of Prophet Muhammad ﷺ. وَحَيْثُمَا كُنْتُمْ فَوَلُّوا وُجُوهَكُمْ شَطْرًا. And wheresoever you people are, turn your faces in that direction. If Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala would have command the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, it would have been command for his followers as well. If Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala would have command, the follower Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam would have been also command for him alayhi wa sallam. But Allah mentioned both to emphasize. وَإِنَّ الَّذِينَ أُوتُوا الْكِتَابَ لَيَعْلَمُونَ أَنَّهُ الْحَقُّ مِنْ رَبِّهِمْ. Certainly, the people who were given the scripture, the book, the Jewish and the Christians, the people of the book, لَيَعْلَمُونَ أَنَّهُ الْحَقُّ مِنْ رَبِّهِمْ, know well that أَنَّهُ الْحَقُّ مِنْ رَبِّهِمْ, that you're turning towards the direction of the Qibla at Mecca in prayer is the truth from their Lord. They know it because that's in their books, that Allah will send a prophet called Muhammad, Ahmad, and at the end he will face in prayer towards the Masjid al-Haram. That's what they had in their books. So if they would have any doubt, the beginning, because the Prophet ﷺ is facing the direction of Baytul Maqdis, even though this is also one of the directions to face in prayer that Allah legislated, but after Allah commanded the Prophet ﷺ to face the Kaaba, the Masjid al-Haram, then that's what they in their books. They should have increased iman if they had iman, and if they had doubt, they wouldn't have any doubt anymore, because that's what's in their books. Therefore, Allah said, "وَإِنَّ الَّذِينَ أُوتُوا الْكِتَابَ لَا يَعْلَمُونَ أَنَّهُ الْحَقُّ مِن رَبِّهِمْ." Indeed, those who were given the book know that it is the truth from their Lord. وَمَا اللَّهُ بِغَافِلٍ عَمَّا يَعْمَلُونَ, and Allah is not unaware of what they do. Allah is unaware of what they do, including the actions of their hearts, which that they know that the Prophet ﷺ facing towards the Kaaba in prayer is the haq, is the truth. Then Allah said, وَلَئِنْ أَتَيْتَ الَّذِينَ أُوتُوا الْكِتَابَ بِكُلِّ آيَةٍ مَا تَبِعُوا قِبْلَتَكَ. And even if you were, or the Messenger of Allah, to bring to the people of the scripture, the Jewish and Christians, bi kulli ayah, all the ayat, all proofs, All evidences, all verses, lessons, signs, revelation, every proof. If you were, including even what they ask, what they suggest, ما تبعوا قبلتك, they wouldn't follow you. They wouldn't follow your قبلة. Why? Because they left it knowingly. When the verses and the signs and the proof is benefit, is for the one who was ignorant, the one who was in doubt. When he received the proofs, he followed it. But someone who already knew the proofs and knowingly he left it, no more proofs will benefit him. Is this understandable? So they already know. So Allah said, ما تبعوا قبلتك ولئن أتيت الذين أوتوا الكتاب بكل آية. نعم. And if you were to bring to the people of the book all ayat, all evidence, all proofs, ما تبعوا قبلتك, they wouldn't follow your qibla. They wouldn't follow you. Whatever. This is tasliyah for the Prophet ﷺ. Prophet ﷺ used to love so much to guide people to their safety, to their success, to get the Jannah, paradise, to be safe from hellfire. He loved so much. In a way, he was about even to die. He used to grieve so much. فَلَعَلَّكَ بَاقِعٌ نَفْسَكَ. You are about to destroy your soul. أَلَّا يَكُونُ مُؤْمِنِينَ. That they are not believers. Because he used to care, صلى الله عليه وسلم, about the people. Love so much. So when Allah told him, informed the Prophet ﷺ that regardless what verses the Prophet ﷺ comes with, they will never believe in him, means, or the Messenger of Allah, take it easy, and they doing what they doing knowingly. And Allah's wisdom is not to enforce anyone in the religion. If Allah would have enforced people to take the truth, no one would have been non-Muslim. Everyone would have been a Muslim. But Allah, out of His wisdom, He gave the option. He showed the haq. He gave us intellect. He sent messengers. He sent them with proofs. He gave us all blessings. He informed us the way to take, the way which leads to His pleasure, the way He dislikes. Then Allah gave the person power and irada and willing to do the good, or if he wants to do the bad. So these people, they know the haq. They left it knowingly. Whatsoever you come up with, or the Messenger of Allah, including what they ask of Basel questions, they will never believe in you. They will never accept it. Which means so, just to convey the message. Naam. And this is the case of everyone who is given the haq. The haq is clear to him. After that, don't waste your time with him. Naam. The one who rejecting the haq. Some people, they may tell you, they say if you bring 1,000 proof, they say they will not take it. Don't waste your time. So after that, don't waste your time. Because they don't want. Allah تبارك وتعالى said, وَمَا أَنْتَ بِتَابِعٍ قِبْلَتَهُمْ وَمَا أَنْتَ بِتَابِعٍ قِبْلَتَهُمْ. Not are you going to follow their qibla, their prayer in direction. You are not following them, or the Messenger of Allah. You are not following the Jewish and Christian in their direction of prayer, because you know that it's not upon the haq. You will stop you to follow them is knowing that that's wrong. That's not the way Allah legislates. But then what stop them to follow your direction is baghya, is envy and jealousy and worldly matters. وما بعضهم بتابع قبلة بعض وما بعضهم بتابع قبلة بعض and they will not follow each other's direction of qibla or direction in prayer even they among themselves they don't follow one another so it is not only you who they don't follow they even don't follow one another among themselves then Allah said وَلَئِنِ اتَّبَعْتَ أَهْوَاءَهُمْ وَلَئِنِ اتَّبَعْتَ أَهْوَاءَهُمْ and verily if you O Messenger of Allah Muhammad follow their desires مِن بَعْدِ مَا جَاءَكَ مِنَ الْعِلْمِ after that which you have received of knowledge after that which you have received of knowledge إِنَّكَ إِذًا لَّمِنَ الظَّالِمِينَ If you follow their desires after that which you have received of knowledge from Allah, then indeed you will be one of the ظَالِمِينَ one of the wrongdoers, one of the sinners. In this ayah, Allah said, وَلَئِنِ اتَّبَعْتَ أَهْوَاهُ ولئن اتبعت أهواءهم if you follow their desires because what they are upon is desires Allah didn't say if you follow their proofs as he said if you would have come up with all proofs as for them if you would follow their desire because they don't have proofs they follow in desire whatever they like If you follow their desires after you have received the knowledge, then indeed you are, in this case, you would be from the Zalimun. If this is the case of Prophet Muhammad ﷺ, with the righteous deeds he has, with the high status he has, if he leaves the haq, the truth, the knowledge he has from Allah, and instead he followed desire, that he is going to be from Zalimun, How about the rest of the people who do not have that level? They don't have those ocean of righteous deeds. So he's warning someone to follow desire after he came to know the haq and the truth. مِن بَعْدِ مَا جَاءَكَ مِنَ الْعِلْمِ إِنَّكَ إِذَا لَّمِنَ الظَّالِمِينَ After the ilm, what ilm is? After the ilm has, after you receive the ilm, what's the ilm that Prophet ﷺ received? What's the knowledge that Prophet ﷺ received? Is what? The ilm is the revelation. Is the wahi, is the Quran. And the sunnah of the messenger. This is the knowledge. There are something which is knowledge and there is something which is not knowledge. People may think even that which is not a knowledge and knowledge. But the knowledge is, قال الله قال رسوله قال الصحابة وما سوى ذاك وسواس الشيطان إمام شافعي وسناريت العلم is Allah said قال رسوله his messenger said قال الصحابة the companion said how companion said is revelation how companion said is علم who knows how the companion said قال الصحابة How is it a knowledge? Yes. Very good. Okay. So here it means, this is means the ijma, the consensus. Qala sahaba, the companion said. So what the companion are agree upon. Okay. It is ilm. Is a knowledge. Because Prophet ﷺ said, لا تجتمع أمتي على ضلالة. My ummah will never agree upon falsehood. And the leaders of the ummah are the people of knowledge. They are those who their witness is being concerned, not the general people who are upon ignorance, desires, rather the people of knowledge. who have this quality. They have knowledge of the revelation, and they are judging by the knowledge. There are people who don't have the knowledge, and there are people who have the knowledge, but they don't follow the knowledge. And there are people who have the knowledge, and they follow the knowledge. They are the third group who their witness is being accepted. They are the people of knowledge. Especially the heirs of the people of knowledge are the companion of the Prophet ﷺ. لا تجتمع أمتي على الضلالة. So what they agree upon is haq. If Sahaba, the companion among themselves, they differ in issue. Now, okay, don't bring a third opinion. Never. In any issue, Sahaba, they have different opinion. Naam, don't bring a third one. Choose one of those opinions the Sahaba have. Return it back to the Sunnah. Because when it comes to us individual, the Sahaba, as individual, they are not perfect. But as a group, all of them, yes, perfect. They will not gather on wrong thing. But as individual, it may. The Sahabi may not know that hadith. It happened. Let alone anyone else. Even Abu Bakr radiallahu ta'ala anhu. There are hadith who was reminded. The hadith of inheritance. He was reminded. He didn't know that. When he was asked, he said, I don't know that in the book of Allah. I don't see that in the book of Allah. And I don't know in the sunnah. Let me ask the people. When he asked, the Sahaba, they told him that there is this sound hadith. That this hadith, Prophet ﷺ judged this woman such and such. Bakr, he took it. Likewise, Umar. They are those who know the deen after Prophet ﷺ more than anyone else. But yet they miss some hadith. Ridwanullahi ta'ala alayhim. And sometimes they may know the text, but they may understand, they may differ in the understanding. Can that be happen? Sahaba, they know the text, the exact word of the Prophet ﷺ, but yet they differ. It may happen. One of them, he take the wording as it is, literally. Another one, he says, no, Prophet, he didn't mean the wording. He mean the meaning. Never forget that hadith. In Bukhari and others, Prophet ﷺ and Sahaba, don't pray Asr until you reach there. لا يصلين أحدكم إلا في بني قريظة. They heard it. Don't pray Asr prayer except in that place. Asr prayer time came, different opinion. Some they say they go on their way. Because Prophet ﷺ said, don't pray Asr until you reach there. Some of them said, Prophet ﷺ, he means to hasten, to rush, not to leave the Asr prayer. They pray. Who doing this? Sahaba, who heard Prophet ﷺ saying. So is it authentic? Is it not authentic? That's not the question. But yet they have, and all of them are sincere. The ulama, the heirs of the people of knowledge. Subhanallah, Allah has wisdom. There are lessons. When Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam came to know and he was informed, who you think Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam blamed? None of them. He didn't say those were wrong, he didn't say those were right. Even the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he meant, scholars they mention only one meaning. He either meant sallallahu alaihi wasallam, Shaykh Uthaymeen says he meant the meaning. The Prophet, he meant the meaning, not the wording, literally, don't pray Asr. He wanted Sallallahu to hasten. That's the opinion of Shaykh Uthaymeen. Some scholars have a different opinion. So, Prophet, he meant one meaning. But when he realized the Sahaba, they differ, the one who mistake, he get a reward. Because he tried his best. Because in the Sharia, sometimes it doesn't mean the wording. It means the meaning. The meaning. As the Sahabi, one of the Sahaba, when he heard the ayah in fasting, حتى يتبين لكم الخيط الأبيض من الخيط الأسود, he took the wording. That was not what the Prophet ﷺ wanted. So he corrected him, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. إِنَّ وِسَادَتَكَ الْعَارِيدِ. So it may. المهم, Prophet ﷺ saw so the one who misunderstood, he get a reward. The one who understood, he get two rewards. How to blame someone who did his best? So when the scholars, the ulama, the sahaba, the companion, they differ, now you look what one. Alhamdulillah. But don't bring a third opinion. Naam, if they differ. But if they agree upon, hala ilm, knowledge. And if this is the case of the companion, then how about the ulama? Can't they differ an issue? Can the scholars differ an issue? Any issue, fiqh issue, akhlaq issue, manhaj issue, they can differ. And it happened. So now what to do is the same way. Look, if they agree upon, they don't agree upon for suit. Naam. But if they differ, now look for the ilm, the knowledge. Which one is close to the قال الله قال الرسول قال رسوله قال الصحابة. Naam. With this issue, the people of knowledge is Scholar of Al-Sunnah differ. Naam. There's no one who in each subject, in each field, he the one who knows the best. This is not the understanding of Salaf Salih. Even Imam Shafi'i, he didn't learn that from Imam Malik. That whatever Imam Malik says, Imam Shafi'i must take it. No, that's why he differed in many issues. Because Imam Malik trained him to follow the haq. He trained him, he taught him, kullun raddun wa mardud illa sahib hadha al-qab. Everyone is refuted and he is refuted except the one who is in this grave. He means Prophet Muhammad sallam. This is the aqidah Ahlul Sunnah they used to teach people to follow the texts, the knowledge, not individuals. Not individual, one, two individuals, regardless how higher that scholar is. لِأَنَّ الْعِلْمُ قَالَ اللَّهُ قَالَ رَسُولُهُ قَالَ الصَّحَابَ. Now, that's for the one who can know it. But if you don't have a knowledge, you cannot know it. In this case, you are allowed to follow the opinion of one scholar. Because that's all I can. Sometimes the issue is very detailed. In a way, it's very hard to note because of the principles they're using when it comes to hadith science, when it comes to fiqh, when it comes to qawa'id, the principles. You may even get confused. Here, you are allowed to blind follow the opinion of this sheikh. But it's not because it's because of Sheikh Albani says he should have a type of a religion that he knows this subject more, for instance. He is older, for instance. Whatever of leaning into religion, even when you choose one of them, you don't choose by I love him more or he's my special sheikh. La. It's because he emphasized this issue more than and the like. But in this case, you do not know still. You do not know still. You just allow it. So you, what do you do then? You have to know your level. You are not upon a knowledge. Choosing the opinion of that sheikh, well, there are other sheikhs, people of knowledge, who differ. Imam Shafi has that opinion. His student, Imam Ahmad, has another opinion. Imam Malik is sheikh. Imam Shafi is sheikh. Imam Malik has another opinion. Choosing one of their opinion doesn't mean you are upon a knowledge. If you are not using قال الله قال رسول قال الصحابة, you just said okay, I take the opinion of Imam Shafi'i since he is the sheikh of Imam Ahmad bin Hanbal. Or you say no, since Imam Ahmad bin Hanbal is more knowledgeable when it comes to hadith science, I take, for instance, it's fine. But no, you are not upon a knowledge. Therefore, you don't boycott Imam Shafi'i nor anyone who chooses his opinion. Why are you boycotting? Upon what? He didn't follow your desire. These are the issues that there are ijtihad. Scholars of Ahl-Sunnah, they differ. You worship Allah upon a knowledge. What you don't know, it, You don't know it. Many times you find people, they fight for something they have no knowledge. You ask, what's your proof? Nothing. The best he can, this sheikh said this. There's another sheikh who said this. Based on the usul al-sunnah wal-jama'ah, the opinions of the ulama, يعني الحق, شالباني used to repeat, اعرف الحق تعرف أهله. Know the truth and you know it is people. Know the truth, you know it is people. Who is upon the haq? So here it's very important to be upon a knowledge. وَلَيْنِ اتَّبَعْتَ أَهْوَاءَهُ مِنْ بَعْدِ مَا جَاءَكَ مِنَ الْعِلْمِ. So من العلم is from Allah. العلم, the knowledge is the revelation, is the Quran and the sunnah of the messenger. This is the knowledge. Therefore, أهل السنة, they have those principles. الأدلة, القرآن والسنة والإجماع والقياس. These are the proofs. Not the majority of the people, not who you like, who you hate. La. Allah said, the messenger said, the Sahaba said, the consensus, or the sound, what? Qiyas? Analogy. The sound. Because it has the principles of analogy. إلحاق فرع بأصل في الحكم لعلة جامعة بينهما. المهم, knowledge is very important. من بعد ما جاءك من العلم إنك إذا لمن الظالمين. Then Allah سبحانه وتعالى said in this ayah 146, الذين آتيناهم الكتاب يعرفونه كما يعرفون أبناءهم. Indeed, those whom we gave the scripture, the Jewish and Christian, recognize him, the Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam, or the Kaaba at Mecca, يعني facing in prayer towards the Kaaba. They know it, they recognize it, as they recognize their sons, their own sons. وإن فريقا منهم لا يكتمون الحق وهم يعلمون. But verily a part of them conceal the truth while they know it. Here, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, الَّذِينَ أَتَيْنَاهُمُ الْكِتَابَ يَعْرِفُونَهُ كَمَا يَعْرِفُونَ أَبْنَاهُ. Those to whom we gave the scripture, the Jewish and Christian, recognize him, the messenger, or recognize the turning towards the Kaaba in prayer is haq, is truth, as they know their own sons. Anyone who is wise, intellect, knows his son. Is there anyone from the fathers who are here now in the masjid or the mothers who cannot differentiate between his son, his daughter, and someone else? And he takes time, he look, he doesn't know. La, he knows. So likewise, like that, the people of the book, they know that Prophet ﷺ facing towards Kaaba, the Masjid Haram, is the truth. Because they have that in their books before Allah sent Messenger Muhammad. But what happened? وَإِنَّ فَرِيقًا مِّنْهُمْ لَا يَكْتُمُونَ الْحَقَّ وَهُمْ يَعْلَمُونَ. But verily a part of them conceal the truth while they know it. If they wouldn't know, would have been another case. Ignorant, they don't know it. They shouldn't deny them anything. If they wouldn't know it, they should remain quiet. They wouldn't blame the Prophet ﷺ facing the Kaaba if they don't know it. That's at least, if someone doesn't know something, he remain quiet. Who can enforce you to say something you don't know? The Sharia tells you whether you don't know it, don't say it. وَلَا تَقْفُ مَا لَيْسَ لَكَ بِهِ عِلْمٍ. Don't follow what you have no knowledge of it. Don't jump to it. Don't say it. So these people of the book, they were two groups. One group who know the haq. And knowingly, they left it. And another group who didn't know it. But at the same time, opposed the haq. Because they following their elders. داير شيخس. الله said الحق من ربك فلا تكن من الممترين. The truth from your Lord is from your Lord. So be you are not one of those who doubt. So be you not one of those who doubt. The truth is from your Lord. Because the people of the book, they have a lot of talk. Oh, one day he was in this Qibla, now another Qibla, and this, they confuse people. So Allah emphasized the issue, subhanahu wa ta'ala, this is haq from Allah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in this ayah, verse 148, وَلِكُلِّنْ وِجْهَةٌ هُوَ مُوَلِّيهَا فَاسْتَبِقُوا الْخَيْرَاتِ أينما تكونوا يأتي بكم الله جميعا إن الله على كل شيء قدير ولكل وجهة هو موليها. And for every nation there is a direction to which they face, means in their prayers. فاستبقوا الخيرات, so hasten towards the خيرات, hasten towards the good, hasten towards all good. All that is good. أينما تكونوا يأتي بكم الله. Wheresoever you may be, Allah will bring you together on the day of resurrection. إن الله على كل شيء قدير. Truly Allah is all able to do all things. In this ayah, Allah mentioned that every nation had a direction to face in their prayer. So when it comes to the direction of the prayer, it didn't have only one direction. It used to have different directions. Even Prophet Muhammad, he himself, the beginning of Al-Islam, his direction used to be Baytul Maqdis. Then after time, Allah abrogated that to face the Kaaba. So as for facing directions in prayer, it goes to Allah, Tabaraka wa Ta'ala. All directions belong to Him. He is the one who, subhanahu wa ta'ala, legislates for His messengers the directions He wants. And the point is to obey Allah. It's not the direction itself. فَاسْتَبِقُوا الْخَيْرَاتِ, so make istibaq, hasten. Compete one another towards all that is good. فَاسْتَبِقُوا الْخَيْرَاتِ. Compete in one another towards all that which is good. In prayer, in fasting, in hajj, in charity, helping the needy, maintaining the ties of relative, spreading the knowledge, advising. Compete one another towards that which is good. In this ayah, not only Allah command to do the good, but also He command to hasten to it. Means to do it from the beginning of it. For instance, Hajj. This year you're financially capable. You're financially capable, health, everything. Don't delay it. Do it. The Salah is the beginning of the time. The origin is to perform at the beginning. Don't delay it. Because this is istibaq ila al-khayrat, hastening to the good. Likewise, giving the zakah, the charity, everything, to do it the first time. Unless there is in the sharia to delay is better. Like the dhuhr prayer, is the best is to pray from beginning, unless it's hot, then the sunnah is to delay it. Isha, the best is to delay Isha to very late. But if that will be hard on the people, then to pray from the beginning, whenever the Jama'ah come. But the origin is to do it from the beginning, except those exceptionals. أَيْنَمَا تَكُونُ يَأْتِ بِكُمُ اللَّهِ جَمِيعًا. Wheresoever you may be, Allah will bring you together. Wheresoever you may be. Whether you are on the, you die on the ocean, or you die on the air, or you die on a ground, under a rock, نعم. Wherever. سبحان الله يأتي بكم الله جميعا. Allah will bring you all. Allah will bring you all. So this is فَاسْتَبِقُوا الْخَيْرَاتِ. Do the good. Because you will get it. Wherever you may be, you will be brought by Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala with your actions. Therefore, make istibaq ila al-khayrat. Hasten to the khayrat. Inna Allah ala kulli shayin qadir. Someone may say how everyone will be brought. People die at different time, in different area, a great number of people. Inna Allah ala kulli shayin qadir is the answer. Truly Allah is able to do all things. Subhanahu wa ta'ala, yes, to the people, to the creation is hard. But to the creator, to Allah, إنما أمره إذا أراد شيئاً أن يقول له كن فيكون. If Allah wants something to be, He just says be. He says be, is going to be. سبحانه وتعالى. Creating one soul and creating all soul to Allah is the same. ما خلقكم ولا بعثكم إلا كنفس واحدة. Your creation and your resurrection is nothing but ماذا؟ Like one single soul. To Allah تبارك وتعالى إن الله على كل شيء قدير. So when it comes to Allah تبارك وتعالى على كل شيء قدير فعال لما يريد سبحانه وتعالى. Allah تبارك وتعالى knows every piece of us wherever what we turn into after we die. Everything sees the same way. As Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, our physical appearance, He also sees our in heart and our thoughts the same way. Tabaraka wa ta'ala is beyond our imagination. لأنه Allah tabaraka. That's why Allah is ahad. What is the meaning of ahad? نعم, unique. يعني no comparable. No one resembles Him. Beyond our imagination. هو الله tabaraka wa ta'ala. And see His creation. Just look at the sky. How far the sky is. How many miles the sky is from us. Have you seen any pillars? Any pillars holding it up? Like we have this small masjid. How many walls? How many pillars? This huge sky. Far. How many years you think He was built? 10 years? 3 years? Allahu Akbar. Do you see any split? Any crack down? One roof certain falling down like happened to the masjid. Little rain come, a roof come down. نعم, لا. أَفَلَمْ يَنْظُرُوا إِلَى السَّمَاءِ فَوْقَهُمْ كَيْفَ بَنَيْنَاهَا وَزَيَّنَّاهَا وَمَا لَهَا مِنْ فُرُوجِ. Look how the sky is beautiful. How the stars moving, يا أخي, the sun, since how many years. How strong it is. How much heat it has. How benefit is to us. You cannot. وَمَا قَدَّرُ اللَّهِ حَقَّ قَدْرِهِ وَالْأَرْضُ جَمِيعًا قَبْضَتُ يَوْمَ الْقِيَامِ وَالسَّمَاوَاتُ مَطْوِيَّاتٌ بِيَمِينِ. All the skies, seven heavens, are what? مَطْوِيَّاتٌ بِيَمِينِ. Folded up in the hand of Allah. In Allah's right hand. Both the hands of Allah are right hand. All the seven skies. When these people who talk about astronomers, they talk about how huge this universe is. It's beyond our imagination, ya akhi. They tell you this sun is bigger than the earth million of time. Over, they say how many times? They say some of the stars are bigger than the earth, bigger than the sun itself, the same, more than that. They say one galaxy is how many things? Galaxy, how many billions of it? And all that they tell you is one, just a one part. What they know is from the universe, comparing to what they don't know, is nothing. They're only talking about the first sky. And between the two, the sky itself, the depth of it is between two skies. So between the earth and the sky is what's between the sky itself, one sky. How strong it is to remain that long. نعم, then the second heaven, the third heaven, the fourth heaven, the fifth, all of that together to the chair of Allah is nothing. Na'am, Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala, Prophet Musa was taught by Khidr. He said, "Oh Khidr, do you see this bird which took water, put his beak into the ocean, and it took some out?" "Yes." He said, "Your knowledge, O Prophet Musa, and my knowledge together, comparing to the knowledge of Allah, is with this ocean and what the bird took out of it. What beard the bird took, just to put in, what it took from the ocean." Subhanallah. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, "Inna Allah ala kulli shay'in qadir." "Inna Allah sami'un basir." "Na'am, inna Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala." So don't say how Allah is bringing together all those people. Know how when it comes to Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala. Wallahu a'lam, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam ala nabiyyina Muhammad.